All right, this is my contrast entry for the White Hat holsters. What I like and dislike about inside the waistband holsters. Let me clear my weapon before I do this. And drop the hammer, put it on safe. All right. What I dislike about them first. I don't really have, I'm kind of doing this video on a whim, so I don't really have a bunch at my disposal right now, but let's just say it's one of these little cheaply made little nylon holsters, okay, for inside the waistband. Yeah, it's comfortable because it's nylon, it's soft, it's thin, but, you know, after you draw your pistol out of one of these, it collapses. And reholstering when it's inside your pants is a pain in the ass. You got to dig your finger in there, find it, wedge your one finger in, and then get your pistol back in there. That's annoying. Nobody wants to do that. That sucks. And then, say, you know, some of the Kydex ones that, you know, basically they clip to your belt or your belt buckle, whatever. Or belt buckle, your belt or your pants, and they just kind of clip in there. They're uncomfortable. They're hard as hell. You know, you sit on them, they hurt. They get in the way. They're bulky. So the Kydex ones are bad too. I've tried some. I won't mention brand names, but you know, I've tried some that were leather, or some that were Kydex. You know, and the leather ones, yeah, they're all right, but they weren't. It's like they were, like on these, the White Hat holsters, the side that faces out away from your body is that smooth leather that's kind of, I don't know, kind of sticky against your skin. It was like that on the back, too, the part that touched you. So it'd get all sweaty and sticky and gross. And no, that's annoying. You know, it needed to be something like suede or some kind of soft fabric or something like that on the back side that touches your body. You know, and nothing rough like plastic touching your body or anything like that. I've seen some that are similar to the White Hat holsters where you can replace the little scabbard that goes on them for different guns, but the screws would go all the way through, and now you got the screws scratching you and digging in. That was pretty annoying. I don't know if White Hat holsters are like that or not. I've heard nothing but good things about them, but you know, I'm not sure if their screws are like that or not. But if so, you know, apparently this guy's looking for tips, and I'm not trying to down the product, but if that's the way it is, you know, the screw's scratching you, that kind of sucks. You know, maybe something over them, you know, like on the back side, like I said, a sheet of suede or something to cover it up so it's a little softer on you or something. Things I like about them. I love the fact that they have inside the waistband holsters now that you can tuck your shirt into. Didn't used to be that way. That's awesome. That's a very good improvement. You know, and the main reason I think everybody likes them, just concealability, hiding the gun. I like a slim, flatter profile, less printing. You know, I mean, with an outside, they do have concealment holsters that go on the outside, but they print. You know, on the inside, especially when you can tuck your shirt in, it's on the inside of your clothing. Has a flat, slim profile, and it'll cover the print of the gun because you have your pants doing this. So it just looks like the outline of your pants, especially if you're wearing a belt that hides it even more. You know, so you know, I don't really quite know the whole ins and outs of inside the waistband holsters, but this is just a few of my opinions. You know, the biggest thing is concealability and comfort. Probably the third largest thing, for me anyways, is retention. Retention doesn't have to be adjustable on an inside the waistband holster, not in my opinion, because, you know, the tighter you make your belt, the tighter it is. You know, that's just the way it is. The tighter your belt is around it, the tighter it is against your body, and it's in there. But retention, you know, it does have to have some sort of retention. even if it's just a level one retention where it locks into the trigger guard, where, you know, the molded retention, that's perfect. Just a little molded scabbard, just enough to grab it around this way and hold it. You know, so retention's a big issue. Not too much, not too little. You just got to have that, just that right combination of a little bit of grab without it being too hard, because you are reaching back awkwardly to get your weapon. So comfort, concealability, retention, how it looks, yeah, it's fun to be able to customize it and put different looks on it, but who sees it? You know, it's a concealment holster. It's not supposed to be seen. That's the point. So, you know, not trying to impress anybody. I'm very much function over form anyway. I don't really care how it looks. Anything else I like or dislike about inside the waistband holsters? You know, I really can't come up with anything else right off the top of my head. So I'll just end it here. And, you know, thanks for letting us all know about this, man. And thanks for doing this for us. And in case I'm busy, and, you know, if I don't win, and in case I'm busy at the moment, you know, congratulations to the winners, whoever gets it. All right.